The PLC that I'm going to use to run this three-phase electrical motor with star delta starter is a Siemens S7 PLC. The software package that Siemens has provided for programming these types of PLCs is Step 7. In the previous lesson, I created a new project in Step 7 and then began configuring the PLC modules in the hardware. In this lesson, I'm going to complete the hardware configuration, and then I'm going to download it to the PLC. Based on the modules that I have on the rack in the actual environment, I've placed two PLC modules on the rack in the software so far. The first module is the power supply, and the next module is the CPU. The next module that I need to add to the rack is a 32-point digital input module. To find this DI module, I should look into the SM300 folder and then open the DI300. Here, as you can see, there's a long list of different digital input modules. The order number of the DI module that I have on the rack in the actual environment is 6ES7321BL00OAAO. So here in the software, I need to double-click on this module and add it to the rack. When I do this, as you can see, it gives me a warning saying that I'm not able to insert any module except an interface module in slot 3. So, I'm going to select the next slot and insert the DI module there. Now, why can't I insert my module in slot 3? In the software environment, slot 3 may contain only an interface module. This means you cannot insert any other module in the slot besides an interface module. Now, what if you didn't have an interface module among all the modules that you're going to use in your project? In that situation, you would simply leave this slot empty. Now, you may ask, when I don't have an interface module and I leave slot 3 empty in the software, do I need to do the same in the actual environment as well? The answer is no. Why? Because if you do that, the CPU won't be able to communicate data within the rest of the PLC modules. So when you don't have an interface module in your project, you leave slot 3 empty in the software. But in the actual environment, you place the PLC modules right next to each other and without any empty space. The next module that I need to place on the rack is the digital output module. The DO module that I have in the actual environment is a 16-point digital output module, and its order number is 6ES7322 1BH81OAAO. So here, I'm going to open the DO300 folder, and from these 16-point digital output modules, I will select this module to add it to the rack. Okay, now the configuration is done, and I can download the hardware to the PLC or the simulator. To run the PLC simulator, all I need to do is go to the Somatic environment and click on this Simulator On-Off icon. As you can see, the simulator is in the stop mode at the moment. To put the simulator into the run mode, I will simply check this box here. To have the simulator window stay on the computer screen, from the View menu, I will select Always on Top. Now the simulator is active and ready. To download the hardware to the PLC simulator, the first thing that I do is save and compile the hardware, Then I'm going to hit Download to Module here in the toolbar. In the Select Target module, I need to select the CPU that I'm going to download the hardware to. Here, since I only have one CPU and there is no industrial network, it only shows one CPU, which is on slot 2 of rack 0. So, I will select this CPU here and then click OK. In the next window, I need to select the MPI address for the CPU that I'm going to download the hardware to. To do this, I click on View, choose the desired MPI address, and then click OK. When the PLC is in run mode and you're downloading the hardware, the PLC always goes to the stop mode. Here, it warns me that this will happen if I download the hardware to the CPU. In the next window, it asks me if I want to run the CPU again. I choose Yes, and as you can see, the CPU goes into the run mode again. Okay, I configured the hardware and then successfully downloaded it to the PLC simulator. Now, let's go to the next lesson and start writing a PLC program that can fully control an electrical motor with a star delta starter. Now, here's what I want from you in the comments below this video. What have you learned from watching this video? Can you imagine implementing something from this video in your next PLC programming project? A great motivator for us to produce free, valuable content for you is the audience's acknowledgement that they found this video useful. If that describes you, please hit the like button. That will also help others to more easily find our videos on YouTube. Be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel if you haven't already done so. When you subscribe, each new video will be sent to you as quickly as it's published. Thank you so much for watching. RealPars has a large, continually growing library of practical programming lessons. Visit realpars.com, where you can sign up for a free 1-month trial. In your trial, you'll have instant access to our entire library, as well as the new videos that are produced weekly. With these videos, you'll advance your programming skills using step-by-step, easy-to-follow practical programming examples. You'll also have access to the Questions and Comments arena, where you're encouraged to ask questions, make suggestions, collaborate with peers, write about your experiences, and have the opportunity to network with people that are interested in the same professional field that you are. You may cancel your subscription at any time. To learn more, head on over to realpars.com now, where your free trial awaits. You're just a few short clicks away from learning valuable skills and starting your path to a new career.